President Marcos on Thursday also led the signing of an agreement between the Agriculture and Justice Departments aimed at addressing food security. The Reformation Initiative for Sustainable Environment for Food Security, or RISE Project, seeks to develop arable lands in prison reservations and penal farms of the Corrections Bureau. Marcos, who is the concurrent Agriculture Secretary, says aside from boosting food production, the initiative will also help reform and reskill persons deprived of liberty. The initiative will be piloted at the Iwahig Penal Colony and Prison Farms in Palawan. The South Commuter Railway project seen to generate around 3,000 jobs. That's according to President Marcos during the contract signing for three more segments of the project in Malacañang yesterday. Those cover the Blumintrit Station, the Buendia EDSA Senate Station, and the Bikutan Sukat Station, spanning nearly 15 kilometers. Marcos says once completed, this will benefit up to 800,000 commuters daily.
We continue to show the commitment to realizing the dream of a more efficient and inclusive public transportation system that every Filipino deserves. We must also recognize the plight of informal settler families who will be affected by the project, as well as the disturbances that the construction of the NSCR system will cause. These are the inevitable consequences of this large project, but it is something that we have to go through if we are going to complete the projects as they have been designed, and we will to be able to reap the benefits in the longer term.
The South Commuter Railway Project is part of the North-South Commuter Railway System. It's a major railway project that's going to link Pampanga, Bulacan, Metro Manila, and Laguna. Now, the operations of the Philippine National Railways will be suspended for 5 years to give way to this construction. Amid an ongoing maritime dispute, the Philippines and China are strengthening trade ties as they target establishing a cooperation zone for economic development. Jackie Pascual reports.
Despite maritime tensions, China and the Philippines are beefing up economic and trade ties. Hundreds of delegates from Zhangzhou City in Fujian Province, China, are in Manila for an economic conference. Philippine Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual welcomed the business delegates as he said both sides can take advantage of the momentum brought by the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, which took into force in the Philippines just last month.
We are encouraging Chinese businesses from Zhangzhou to continue their engagement and explore business opportunities in the Philippines.
China's ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Silian, also highlighted the growing trade relations of the two countries.
Our bilateral trade reached $87.73 billion. China has been the Philippines' largest trading partner for 7 consecutive years.
While the maritime dispute was not mentioned, the two officials signified their intent to improve relations of the two nations.
The next 5 years will be very crucial for China's development agenda.
I would like to assure our Chinese counterpart that the Philippine government has the support for your investors. Remember that China and the Philippines share a rich history and a vibrant cultural connection.
The conference aims to create a cooperation zone for economic innovative development between Manila and Zhangzhou, where they could explore investments in various areas, energy and cold storage. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
This Philippine economic managers are in Toronto for their first economic briefing in Canada and their last roadshow before President Marcos' second State of the Nation address. There, the economic team urged Canadian businesses to explore investments in Manila.
Uncharted waters to explore in terms of trade and investments in mutual areas of interest, including electronics, manufacturing, machineries, and electricity, mining and agriculture. In 2022, Canada emerged as the country's 20th largest trading partner, with total trade reaching $1.5 billion. Year one of the Marcos administration demonstrated the Philippine economy's remarkable ability to rise above the tide and grow beyond expectations. Following a 46-year high growth performance of 7.6% in 2022, we are seeing continued rapid growth amid a slowing global economy.
The Philippines is making a pitch particularly for collaboration in the energy sector, with the Philippines recently opening up the renewable energy sector to full foreign ownership. And Canada, well, Canada is a global leader in clean energy with 68% of its total generation already clean. The Bureau of Internal Revenue ramps up its crackdown against the illicit cigarette and alcohol trade. The agency conducted raids in Nueva Ecija, Camarines Norte and Sur, Bacolod and Davao, as well as cities in Metro Manila. It seized millions of pesos worth of alcohol and cigarettes in Makati, for example, with most products bearing Chinese logos and characters, all of them missing excise tax stamps, proof that these were imported and taxed. The confiscated items will be used for case filing before they are destroyed. The Bureau noted that sin tax collection had been weak for several years. The agency is currently 20% short of this year's excise tax collection goal, estimating that government is losing anywhere between 50 to 100 billion pesos a year in tax revenues from illicit trade. Now, in 2022, the Bureau collected 261.6 billion pesos in excise taxes from sin products. That's 2% lower than collections from 2021. The Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission set to ask the Court of Appeals to reconsider its ruling, which voided ERC's denial of the rate hike petitions filed by Meralco and San Miguel Corporation. Now, last year, the San Miguel Group, along with the power distributor, filed for a rate hike of 30 centavos per kilowatt hour, citing their surge in their operating costs. However, the ERC denied that petition, saying that it had no basis since the power supply agreement is a fixed rate contract. The court had said the energy regulator acted with grave abuse of discretion when it made the decision. ERC says Meralco rates won't be affected yet since the decision is not yet final, adding it may file for a motion for reconsideration and even go all the way to the Supreme Court. Meralco and San Miguel Corporation, meanwhile, welcoming the latest development. San Miguel Global Power says the court's decision upholds the constitutional mandate of due process that guarantees the right to be treated fairly and effectively. A new tourism sector is emerging in Argentina, and that's supermarket tourism. Residents from border towns are crossing into Argentina to shop for cheap food and fuel. These as Argentina's over 100% inflation and weak currency have brought prices of goods tumbling down. It's a bane, though, for some businessmen in the border who are now unable to compete with Argentine prices. High levels of unemployment and bankruptcies have been reported in those towns.